research for us this week will be research into a material. Material research is thinking. It is research, and it's a serious endeavor. We're going to play around with a lot of that this week. What we're here to try to do is to work with you on a larger project that for us, and I think for many people, is part of the leading edge of design disciplines right now.
It all starts with cement. Once you have cement in a material mix, you can say, this is concrete.
What we see? We don't see what is inside the concrete. Inside the concrete, we have the big aggregates.
Information on that you changed, so you had an exhibition or on a cinema.
This is a sketch just done by me.
Je krijgt geen mooie cut, zie je? Als je iets ander foam hebt, het breekt meer af.
So you can remove this and this and this wall.
Yeah, okay. To me, robustness has a certain meaning, which deals more with the robustness of, for instance, an abstract model in mathematics, in physics, or in economics. And you must make sure that there won't be chaotic behavior.
I wouldn't deny that we have an aesthetic perception. What I think is interesting of these methods is that they start from a domain that architects traditionally don't start from. And therefore, I think they may be able to produce things that are not obviously aesthetic. So I wouldn't deny that there are many elements of the choices of things that are based on the grounds of you look at what comes out of it and then you edit it and you choose some things that are better or that are more shocking or more beautiful.
You should also just remember that this is the process we're trying to. Nobody's figured this process out yet. There's no like expert that's working in this way. It's probably not a way you've worked already, but hopefully it's in a week an introduction to a couple of techniques and a way of approaching design that you might never use again, but you'll at least be exposed to it and have some sense of what people are up to. So it's not like we're trying to convert you. Which simply means that there's no right or wrong with this. It's if you can create your own sense of internal rigor about how you work with this, I think it's more important than getting the primitive right or getting the primitive wrong.
So here you see almost there. These grains are becoming visual. And you see that they are simply embedded in the cement matrix. If you have big grains, of course, like you see here, that's, I think, the maximum you can go. If you go deeper than that, then certain grains will just disappear, will just go.
There are at least two or three ways to bring in your own, let's say, fascinations or your own luggage as a designer. And in that sense, I think that
it's
you have to find them, you have to see them, of course.
It's also why it's not automatic design, because if you're asked to generate a kind of design database or data set or matrix of possibilities, there could be billions of possibilities, but you bring your own sort of set of filters to these things, and in a way that selection process is a kind of editing of reality that you would do under any other normal conditions anyway. If you're doing a normal design problem, that's how you would do it. It's just that here we're foregrounding the many, many possibilities that kind of can come from these things. That's pretty much it.
What's so special that these letters?
Well, why don't you consider these things?
Hey, stop! This question, together with a couple of other, let's say, rather important questions, we will hit you over the head tomorrow with that, and not today, because...
So thinking about the self-compacting concrete, that it's flowable,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So you basically fill it at one end.
Go a different angle, so...
It's closed. This one's closed.
Yeah.
Closed.
If this is human scale, it's an enormous piece of concrete.
Yeah.
Can you wear the question of introducing light?
It's big bricks.
This is under pigmented.
No, this is the others. The lasers. I'm working it.
Sometimes people say, well, I think copy is too hard.
Photos and after
you
can
go.
May I touch this?
Yes.
Yeah. Good afternoon and welcome to what we're calling our grand finale. Who are we? Who are the supporters of this project? The sponsors of this competition are basically the cement industry from 8 countries across Europe, from Ireland in the west to Turkey in the east, from Sweden in the north to Portugal in the south, and taking in the Netherlands, Belgium, Germany, and the United Kingdom. The idea of a national competition, the idea of exploring a key material property as a theme, in this case, robustness. I'd like to thank all of you, one and all, for your enthusiastic support throughout this project. It's been absolutely fantastic. It's encouraged us to keep going.
By the people who can do it better, because they're much less encumbered by old ways of thinking, namely students who are young enough not to know any better, but who will later become smart enough to learn ways of doing things and really turn the innovations into new kind of products.
Forwards, as it might appear over the week and even as it might appear 10 years hence. Though not asked for in the brief, CC001 was also the only entry to prototype an actual design component. Attached to the board is a concrete tile fitted with an electrical plug that changes color when current is passed through it. This little presentation innovation made explicit CC01's recognition of the importance of material testing and prototyping. Ultimately, all jurors were agreed that in almost every respect, CC001 was an extremely strong proposal that deserved to be recognized as one of two winners, and we should maybe thank them again for that.